What's going on, boys and girls? Payneblade back here again. All right, everybody. So we talked a little bit about Lost Ark yesterday, and you guys were part of the live stream. And if you weren't, check it out. We had a lot of fun. We did a lot of T3 things, and we talked a lot about the game, covered some of the character creations, and a whole slew of other Lost Ark content, right? So one thing I want to talk about, though, is what is coming down the pipe for Lost Ark, what to expect in the month of March. The update is pretty damn huge, and it's going to bring a lot more players to the fold. Now, if you don't know already, Lost Ark is probably one of the most popular MMORPGs to come out in a very long time. I think on a continuous basis, it's got 800k plus players playing. A lot of people might say that some of those are bots. Clearly, they probably are, but for the most part, they're real players playing this game. This game is extremely popular, and it came out in conjunction with Elden Ring, very close to one another in terms of dates. And the only reason why it hasn't got more players is because Elden Ring obviously took a lot of those players, and you know, it's a split almost down the line. I think Elden Ring has as many players playing that at the same time on Steam as Lost Ark does. So what makes March a huge month for Lost Ark, and why a whole lot of new players are going to be jumping on? I want to explain to you guys the content that you should be expecting and why it's a big deal and why you should pay attention. So first off, all right, the hunt for the Guardian Slayer. Now, if you haven't played the Korean version and the Russian version, this is going to be a little weird for you. And for me personally, I haven't played those either, but I've heard a lot about them and I did some research, right? So let's talk about what is going on and what the spotlight is. So first off, if you have been playing Lost Ark and you know the story is going to continue. The spotlight is going to be the Caden story episode, including Asteri and Illusion Bamboo Islands. So there's going to be new islands plus a main story quest added to the existing one. We know how the story ended if you're already there, and we know there's a lot more to come. So this is good. And I'm telling you now, I play Final Fantasy 14. I am a huge advocate for storytelling in MMORPGs, because you know, ones like WoW did a horrible job, but then you have ones like Final Fantasy that do an incredible job and are known for it. So Lost Ark, I'll say, is very much in the middle, right? It didn't capture me in the beginning, but as the story progressed and you got higher in eye level and the story became a lot more hardcore in terms of its characters and its storytelling, it started to pick up and it started to intrigue me. So I started actually paying attention to the story more. And I'm actually happy to say I'm excited to see where they go with the rest of Lost Ark's storyline. So this is a big one, guys, which will obviously open up brand new areas in the game and will obviously give us a lot more content to work on from a story slash gear perspective. Because this game is very gear heavy and it focuses primarily on getting gear score so you can do raids if you're into that. But the cool thing about Lost Ark also is it has a lot of fun little mini games and achievements that you can do in these new areas if you're already completed things, like getting the Makoko seeds or, you know, finishing the adventure tomes, etc., right? So those are all the things that this new area will bring back into the fold if you're already caught up on all that, which I'd be super super surprised if you are. But that's a cool thing. So experience a new storyline complete with its own quest, new islands, and cinematic moments. These quests will include a cast of new and returning characters and more about the side reels, and search for the legendary Caden, the first Guardian Slayer in your journeys to the final arc. So we only have, actually, I'm not going to spoil it. Play the game, you'll realize how many arcs there actually are. But yeah, this is to go to the journey to the final arc. So players will need to have completed Phaeton, which is a tier 2 section of the game, alongside completing the following quests: Yorn, Let There Be Light, Whispering Islet, start of the story, and Illusion Bamboo Island, end of the trials, as a prerequisite before embarking on the new endgame quest. For Astari and Illusion Bamboo Islands are recommended for players at item level 1100, which is actually the beginning of tier 3. So a lot of people are now transitioning from tier 2 to tier 3, and I believe as we go down this list of updates, you're going to see a big surprise, and one of the big reasons why I think a lot of new players are going to join Lost Ark. So another huge update is the Abyss Raid. So right now in tier 3 content, there is no 8-man raid. There are only the Abyssal Dungeons, which essentially is your classic 4-man. There is a hard version at 1370, and I believe a regular version at 1325. As you guys saw, my character is at 1360. We're going to try to push the 1370 before this comes out, because I believe that is the requirement to do this raid in the first place. And a lot of you were saying that, you know, a lot, like, many players aren't even at 1370, so what's the rush? I just want to be able to do new content as soon as it comes out. That's just my own personal goal. Obviously, right now is not the greatest time to be upgrading because you could be selling to get gold, which is a premium resource in the game, but it's still a good reason. So, Abyss Raid Argos. So this is what it's all about. Similar to the Garden Raids that players have encountered in their adventures across Arkesia, participants will need to work together to defeat Guardian Argos before time expires, with a limited number of revival abilities at the party. As a relentless foe, 8 players are required to face Argos. So, if you haven't done Guardian Raids, you can do up to 4 players. This is the first Guardian Raid that does 8, and it is considered a raid boss. Players will need to progress through 3 distinct phases as they work together to vanquish this powerful Guardian. In the 3 phases, Argos will grow more powerful with different mechanics and attack patterns. Each phase has its own table of rewards, collectible once a week. So this is essentially the same mechanism or loot mechanism as Abyssal Dungeons, which are only once a week. Guardian Raids are once a day, right? So that is different. And a different item level requirement for each phase. Now this is key, guys, right? So 1370 is phase 1. So once you finish 1370, I don't know if you can continue going on. It looks like you phase 1, that is your item level. You stop at 1370, you get your loot, and you're out. So phase 2 requires 1385, which doesn't seem like a lot, guys. But that 15 levels is massive. The success rate for tier 3, as you saw in my video, is extremely low, and it just continues to get lower, and the top end is very low as well. So it's not like you can get to 100%. And phase 3, of course, is 1400. So to face Argos, players must first complete the quest Abyss Raid Unlocked. Those meeting the requirements are able to enter the encounter through the Abyss Raid statue in major cities, where they can look for battle companions through matchmaking or by finding specific groups. Players can also find a group and enter the encounter using the Find Party button, which essentially is your LFR, or looking for groups or looking for raid, in this case, through the minimap. Alright, so that is the big part of the update in terms of content, right? We're going to get a brand new boss that is the first Guardian Raid boss with 3 different phases. And of course a massive requirement in item level, so that is a big one, guys. So that alone is going to make veteran players stick around and perhaps some new players join. General updates. Arkesia Grand Prix. Looking for a change of pace after intense raiding and a competitive PvP, essentially. Looking for further than limited time Arkesia Grand Prix racing event. And I will say, Lost Ark is really good for this. They have a lot of mini games and things to do outside of the game, and you never feel pressured. I think that's the beauty of Lost Ark, and that's something Final Fantasy did so well as well, is the fact that they never pressure you to spend your time playing a game because you have to. It's because you want to. And a lot of people, big content creators like Asmongold, Rich Campbell, and all these other guys, Preach, etc., have talked about this in their videos numerous times, how WoW is a leech for it, but Lost Ark and Final Fantasy 14 do it so well, and this is just to add value to the game, to have fun. If you still want to continue playing, you don't want to do any of the actual game, a story adventure mode raiding, this is a great way to spend your time if you enjoy, you know, staying in the game. So in this mode, 2 teams of 7 players, 7 versus 7, that's pretty big, will compete against each other, racing around a course while transformed and attempting to progress towards the goal while preventing the other team's progression. Progress can be earned by reaching the goal and eating cakes. That's interesting. The Arkesia Grand Prix will be live for roughly a month after the March update until the April update releases. So only 1 month, guys. It's a limited time event, so definitely try it out. I'm assuming he's going to have quite a few achievements and rewards. An NPC named Arkesia Grand Prix Manager will arrive in every major city other than Pridehome, which is the original first city you started, to help you with to enter the event, granting an event daily to go to the arena, quest for players to gain entry. Player must be level 50, so you have to be top end level. Please note there is a known issue that the messaging for this requirement is only available in the English in-game. Interesting. Oh, okay, so they don't have it in other languages, but I'm sure they'll fix that. Alright, so Competitive Proving Ground Season 1. Unlike the other content in March update, the initial March update will lay the groundwork for Season 1 of the Competitive Proving Grounds. Right now, it's just a regular, This is actually the competitive tournaments, I believe they've all talked about in the Korean and the Russian version. And the season will begin later in the month. We'll keep you posted on the exact time the season is going to set to kick off. And this is essentially PvP with rank scores, and your rank is determined based on your score, as the rewards you receive at the end of the season will be based on that. So this is going to be pretty crazy, because PvP and Lost Ark is huge, guys. If you are a PvP player, this is probably one of the most fine-tuned PvP experience I've ever had in any MMO, because it is, at the end of the day, an action MMORPG, and it's probably some of the best content. And the cool thing about it is whales don't have advantages, right? In this game, if you are, it's only about skill. It's about skill. Gear doesn't matter. Your stats, I mean, you get to choose a couple stats here and there based on your character, but level doesn't matter. None of that matters. It's literally skill, and everything is done in a fashion where nobody has an advantage, right? It's all about your skill and your class. So a couple other things that are being added, and this is just quality of life things. New skins added to the Omen skin collection and game store. These cosmetics will change for Royal Crystals. So that's the paid crystals, guys. So you do have to pay for these skins. Unfortunately, that's one part of Lost Ark that I'm not a big fan of course, but that's okay. New login bonuses. The March update will add a new track for players to receive daily rewards for logging and claiming on daily bonuses on a daily basis. Rewards include a variety of helpful materials such as honing crystals, which is huge in tier 3, rapport selection chest, that is some of the rarest stuff to get and one of the hardest stuff to get, card packs, and much more. The track will have 25 daily bonuses alongside additional rewards at 10, 15, and 20 day thresholds. They're currently doing that now actually, so and it's kind of nice to get the additional stuff too. Europe West will be receiving modified login bonuses to help players who moved into the regions to catch up. That's awesome because we all know EU and its struggles. Okay, so notable bug fixes, guys. Fix a DirectX issue, whatever it is what it is. Fix an issue with graphical settings from where the restore to default button would set the graphical settings to a higher instead of default settings. Interesting. Fix an issue supporting the controller support. I've never used a controller personally. For tutorials and other instructions, I've only used mouse and keyboard, and keyboard and mouse I think is the best way to play this game in my opinion. Fix an issue in character creation customization saying the hello tattoo to display backwards. That's a weird one. Fix an issue with Stronghold's Manor UI causing Azurity keyboard input was not properly supported. Okay, fix an issue where the wrong guide video for the Abyssal Dungeon was being played. Okay, fix issues causing players to sometimes be unable to hear or speak to one another when leaving raid group chat. That's a pretty big one, actually. Fix an issue causing hotkey functionality for global chat to not work properly. Fix an issue where the weekly battle item bundle stated it can be claimed 10 times, changing it to reflect the purchase of once a week. Wow. While previously communicated, this issue is fixed in our last update. We continue to work on resolving it and apologize for any other confusion between the updates. So I guess that's just more of a display issue now, not an actual issue itself. Fix an issue in the training room causing the tutorial to stand up movement to disappear too quickly. Okay, it's easy enough. Fix an issue in the Honest Liar quest preventing players from using mouse clicks to advance quest interactions and NPC dialogue. Fix an issue causing the Notice Orca ship skin to be limited to one instead of three. Fix an issue causing the stronghold not display research lock. That one is the biggest issue for me personally. My stronghold is super high, as you guys saw in my live feed, but I can't access a lot of my research because of that. And then fix various backend and minor issues. So what I was talking about in the beginning of the video when I said a lot of players are going to join, there is rumors, guys. This is just rumors, and I was hoping it would cover it here, but it did not. So the rumor is that new players eventually, even alts for existing players, will be able to advance from tier 1 to tier 2 with 100% to allow people to catch up to tier 3 when all the new content comes out. Now, this is obviously not happening in this update. We just went through the whole thing and it's not around. But I'm imagining after Argos, when they start introducing the Legion raids, the hard raids, like the end game raids for 8 man, we're probably going to see a lot of that 100% kick in. Now, some people are not happy about that and some people are ecstatic about it, and I think personally it's a good thing for the game, because at that point, if they're bringing it out when the Legion raids come out, it's too hard for players to catch up and join that content. Some people might be coming in to raid hardcore and they don't want to spend their time leveling, and I think honing is such a big part of this game and it's such a big crux to players, and a lot of people have quit because of it. I think it's smart to allow players to get to tier 3 and experience some end game content at least. So there's the updates, guys. I'm pretty excited about Argos. I'm gonna work on getting myself to 1400 before I stop, and that's gonna be the goal, but it's gonna take a while. So there it is, the Lost Ark and everything that comes with it for this patch update. If you guys have any questions, send them in the comments. Please join me for more Lost Ark content. I'm super excited to be making it, and we'll be covering other games as well too. But right now, everything Lost Ark, that's all I talk about, that's all I breathe right now, and that's all I play. But we will be doing more. Hope this video, guys, helped you out. If you have any questions, again, leave a comment and let me know how it feels. Take care. Bye now. Take care. Bye now.